Here we are at the end of 2020, a year of disruptions, unexpected curveballs, and unprecedented need for cloud computing services globally. And so I thought it could be a great opportunity to look back on some of the most impactful announcements and releases from the cloud people at Microsoft. I've chosen the top five that I believe will make most of a difference in the months and years ahead. And you can disagree all you want by putting your opinion into a comment below, and that way I can tell you why you're wrong. Up next, 2020 Azure top thingy number five. I start with number five, which is one of those services that didn't get much attention back in July when it went into general availability, Firewall Manager. This service adds a much needed central configuration and management to all of your Azure Firewall instances across regions and subscriptions. You can manage rules and security policies centrally, making sure that you are consistently protected across all company firewalls. Not only does it make cloud infrastructure much more manageable and secure, but it also frees up your time for your system administrators to do other more critical tasks. Number four on my list is Spot VMs. Back in April, these discardable VMs came into general availability to fill the gap of hosting development environments and interoperable processes. Spot VMs run in the space of unused capacity of the Azure data centers. They use the compute power that is currently dormant. And while this is a much, much cheaper option for running VMs, it also means that Microsoft can decommission or evict your Spot VM at any time. It does present all new possibilities for running data processing or test environments without paying production VM pricing. You can set a max price you're willing to pay for the Spot VM, and based on availability, you only spin up a new VM when that price is met. As a work tool day to day, Spot VMs are brilliant for any cloud development team. Number three on my list, where's my buddy? Where's the rest of me? Jamie, can you fix this, please? All right, he's on it. Now, as I said, number three is Azure Private Link. Released to general availability for a ton of Azure services in March, Private Link is just that. A private link between your Azure PaaS services and Azure-hosted, customer-owned partner services over a private endpoint in your virtual network. This means traffic never goes over the public internet, but only uses the Microsoft backbone network. You can connect services in multiple regions, and there is an included protection against data leakage. It also means companies can tick the secure traffic box on new services and products, which is extremely important in certain industries like financing and healthcare. Now, speaking of healthcare, Jamie, can you fix this now, please? All right, very funny. Anyway, number two, Azure Arc. Announced at Microsoft Ignite 2019 and gone into general availability in September 2020, Azure Arc lets you manage Windows and Linux servers or even Kubernetes clusters from a single point, whether they're on premises or in other clouds. Yep, manage your Linux VMs on AWS with Azure Arc. This means Azure Monitor, Azure Defender, Azure Update Management, Azure Policy, and many more can now be used for non-Azure VMs, even if they're on-premises as well. And why is this important, you might ask? It gives companies a way to manage everything through Azure, even if they have a hybrid or multi-cloud infrastructure. And most companies do. Very few are all cloud or even all one cloud platform. You can use the same tools, the same scripting, the same monitoring solution, and much more. It simplifies a large part of an environment that often is incredibly complex. And what do you think number one is? Well, to me, it isn't a single service, but rather the incredible expansion of Azure itself. In 2020, we have got new regions in Taiwan, Mexico, Israel, Poland, Spain, Austria, Greece, New Zealand, Sweden, and most importantly, Denmark. That is 10 new regions in 2020 alone. Granted, not all are operational, but the commitment for Microsoft to continue to be a cloud computing leader is undeniable. Now, along with the new regions, Microsoft has pledged millions of dollars towards upskilling and reskilling the workforce in those regions. The cloud computing future is as critical as it can get to industries, world economies, and, well, future jobs. Which is also why we at ACG spend every ounce of energy that we can muster to give you the world's best cloud training. Merry Christmas. 2020 is almost at an end, and it is time for me to go. We're going to have a couple of weeks off, but I will see you first thing in 2021, where I will look at what we can expect from the year ahead in the clouds. Leave a comment below about what you think Azure in 2020 brought to your world. Subscribe to our channel to not miss the weekly updates and a lot more cloud computing content. And join me in bringing in the new year by giving this video a thumbs up. As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, and we look forward to a couple of weeks of relaxation and energizing for the new year. Seek and you shall cloud. So keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and thank you for sticking with us in 2020.